There are various instructions which Prabhupada has given, and some very clear definition as to how one can overcome this insecurity, what it can do to us, what are the consequences, and how one can overcome this. The people who are most fearful are those who are the most insecure. Always fearful in life. What will happen to me? What will happen to something else? Always there is fear. And if we see the definition of fear, bhaya ditya abhinivesha, when the living entity in its constitutional position, in its glory, it is fearless, it is happily engaged in Krishna's service, not worried about this situation, that situation, what will happen after 10 years. Krishna says in one place, Prabhupada says, sarva dharman parityajya mamekam sharanam braja. People ask, will Krishna give me food after 20 years, 30 years? What if I become old? Lots of doubts. So the people who are most fearful are those who are the most insecure. Fear of future. This is one common fear which people always have. What will happen to my job? What will happen to my house? What will happen to my children? What will happen to my wife? What will happen to my husband? Fear of future. I'm always fearful of my life. Next, you put it here, that very nice, the purport, there was a very nice, how to overcome the fear of future, Prabhupada says. The major fear that people experience is fear about the future. Actually, there is nothing in this world but the present. The past is already gone. Its traits and patterns are upon us now. Past is anyway gone. We don't have any control, that's gone. But its traits and patterns are upon us. The future is just around the corner. It is becoming the present moment by moment. The future is manifesting every moment. What is future basically? Future is every moment it is manifesting. It is becoming present. So if we are more conscious about the present, we would not be so fearful about the future. Especially because we would have more control of what form that future would take. So if we are, if we are more conscious about the present, we would not be so fearful about the future. Especially because we would have more control of what form the future would take. What we forget is, what we do now prepares us what we will receive in the future. And this is exactly what karma is. Our present thoughts and activities produce certain future reactions. And the Prabhupada again says, the people who are most fearful are those who are the most insecure. Those who are insecure should take a closer look at their belief systems and lifestyles. Sometimes people are fearful because they are afraid of what someone is going to say, or what someone is going to do, or what are they doing to themselves. Sometimes people are fearful about what they have done or are doing to others. People are also fearful because their life circumstances are not as focused or stable as they would like. These are all different reasons why people are fearful. And then Prabhupada actually says, how do we overcome this? So the presence of fear indicates that there is a poor quality of love in our lives, a weakness in our relationship with God. We don't have a sufficient relationship developed with Lord, and that is the reason there is a fear. Insecurity or fear arises because we want to assert God's position and keep everyone else around us subordinate and under our control. That's one of the reasons. Because we want to take the position of Lord and keep everyone else should follow me, should listen to me. If somebody is not following, then that creates fear or insecurity within. And this is a very interesting, these are all the quotes from various parts of Bhagavatam. This is the last one. The whole material world is filled with such envy that everyone becomes afraid of his neighbors. Every businessman is afraid of his associates, because this material world is the field of activities for all kinds of envious people who have come here to compete with the opulence of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This is Srimad Bhagavatam purport. There are some examples of insecurity before I tell you actually how to overcome, because unless we see some of the people who are victims of this insecurity or lack of faith, we will not know what exactly this is. The people who are most fearful, So there are many examples which we can see from Srila Prabhupada's books. Brahmanas in India are feeling disturbed to see Westerners chant and dance and follow the strict standards of Krishna consciousness. There's a feeling that non-Hindus are not entitled to become Brahmanas. So they were very insecure to see, you know, when the first time we see this Vaishnavas, the Westerners going to Vrindavan and chanting and dancing, they were very skeptical. They were not able to accept it. Suruchi feeling insecure and afraid to see Dhruva playing on his father's lap. She perceives it as a threat to her own position as the king's favorite queen. It's a simple thing. A son is sitting on father's lap. Of course, it's not, you know, not her own son, the stepson. But that simple action of just a son sitting on father's lap giving insecurity to somebody's queen. And she perceives it as a threat to her own position as the king's favorite queen. Chitraketu's queens feeling insecure, seeing Chitraketu showing great appreciation for Kritadwiti for begetting the first child, Harsasoka, and they poisoned and killed the child to get king's attention. And there are so many others. Srila Prabhupada's godbrothers felt insecure and threatened at Srila Prabhupada's attempt to build a temple at Mayapur. We were reading. Actually, they tried to stop the sale of land to the extent. Dhritarashtra always was insecure and felt threatened by the progress of Pandavas. So you get a perception or a feeling of a person who's insecure. The important thing is, how do we overcome this?